Airplanes are, by design, highly redundant. For almost every piece of equipment, there is duplicate equipment with the same function which has the capability to take over the role of its failed counterpart. Some equipment is even triple redundant. Because of this, airplanes remain perfectly airworthy with certain equipment inoperative. When an item is set as inoperative, pilots and engineers call the item deferred. However, there is a set procedure to fly with inoperative items. It requires consultation with an operational document called the Minimum Equipment List, or MEL. Deferring aircraft equipment can only be done on the ground, as it might require maintenance action from the engineering side to get the item deferred in the first place. The MMEL, or Master Minimum Equipment List, is a document prepared by the aircraft manufacturer during aircraft certification. This document lists items in an aircraft that can be deferred with little to no effect on the safety of the operation. This list is approved by the regulatory body of the country in which the aircraft is manufactured. The MEL differs in that it's a specific document prepared by an operator or an airline based on the MMEL. The MEL can only be made more restrictive than the MMEL and not the other way around. The MEL is approved by the airline Civil Aviation Authority. Why an MEL when you have an MMEL, you might ask? Well, one reason is that the MMEL may allow flying with equipment that the local regulators are not too keen to defer. For example, the master list might say that the aircraft can be flown with the GPS inoperative. However, the local regulations might say that an aircraft must always have a GPS if carrying out commercial operations. Most items in the MEL can be deferred only for a set number of days before they need to be brought back to service, while more critical equipment will be deferred for fewer days. This time is known as the repair interval, and it begins a minute after midnight on the day after the item is deferred. It is also important to note that MEL can only be applied until the aircraft starts moving on its own power. Once this phase of the flight begins, the MEL no longer applies. Any defect has to be dealt with as if the aircraft is in the air. And if it is safe to continue, the trip may be continued and the broken item dealt with once the aircraft makes a landing. The aim of this video and accompanying article is to put anyone who is watching or reading at ease. For people outside the industry, when someone says that airlines fly with broken equipment, it might sound very wrong. But as we just highlighted, there are many steps and checks required before an item can be listed inoperative in an aircraft. This ensures that the safety of operations is maintained at all times. Before watching this video, did you know about minimum equipment lists? Let us know by leaving a comment. In addition to our daily YouTube videos, Simple Flying publishes over 150 articles every week. If you're looking for the latest aviation news and insights, visit simpleflying.com.